Welcome to the class, dear students. I am Priyanka Gupta and we are studying your first chapter from your grammar book Impact, and the chapter's name is Nouns. Students, we have completed some parts from the chapter. Just see what have been completed. Nouns definition, that is clear. Kinds of nouns, yes, it is also clear. Numbers of nouns, we have read in last class. Now come to the next. This is your third part from the chapter, agreement of subject and verb. So we will study today about agreement of subject and verb. Now come to the rules. Noun is a very important concept of language. We know that every noun is something, has something or does something. These words are called verbs. Yes, verb has 12 tense forms. Verb has 12 tense forms, of which 5 have singular or plural forms. 5 tense forms have singular and plural forms. We use singular verb with singular noun and plural verb with plural noun. Is that clear? So let's see what are singular nouns and plural nouns. With singular nouns, there will be the use of is, was, has, verb, or the use of s or es. Come to the plural nouns. There will be the use of with plural nouns are, were, have, verb. And there will be the use of root only. Root means the exact particular form of any verb. Just we can say go. And see, come. These are root word. And there will be the use of root word with the plural nouns. See the following. Let's see some examples. A boy. There is a boy. So it is your singular noun. Fears a dog. We have read here. There will be the use of s or es with the singular nouns. So there is the use of fears. So it will be your singular nouns and this is your singular verbs. A boy fears a dog. And let's see here. Boys. This is your plural nouns. Boys fear a dog. And it is your root word. So this is plural verb and this is plural noun. Boys fear a dog. Let's see here. A boy fears a dog. Yes, of course. Singular noun, singular verbs, and this is the form of object. So it is also a singular noun. Now come to this. A boy fears dogs. So this is your singular noun and this is verb which is qualifying a boy. And here is plural object. Now come to the exercise. Let us do 1.9. Fill in the blanks with the correct forms of nouns or verbs given in brackets. Be verbs are your is, am, are, was, were. These are your be forms. So let's see. Two. If here is mentioned two, it means there will be more than one. So it is your plural indicator. So baby will become babies. Two babies are weeping. Clear? Second, the army has the latest weapons. It is your collective noun. Come to the third. Four. So there will be benches need repair. It is your plural verb. Monkeys are jumping upon the roof. Both have done their work. The painter has painted a picture. Many sheep are grazing. Let's see here, students. The singular and plural noun is same in the case of sheep. Two thieves are hiding behind the wall. These buffaloes give a lot of milk. Two donkeys are crushing these bushes. Since there are some special rules, just see what are these. First, some nouns are always used as plural. There are some nouns which can be used as only plural. Let's see, there are some pairs, binoculars and calipers, forceps, spectacles, tongs, trousers, collective nouns, cattle, gentry, people, poultry. Come to the second special rule. Some nouns are always used as singular. Some nouns are always used as singular. Diseases, let's see, there are some diseases which always used as singular. Mumps, tonsils. Students, pay attention. These nouns are looking like plurals, but they always used as singular. Let's see games, cards and billiards. It is your singular. Subjects, economics, mathematics. Collective nouns, crockery, furniture, poetry, scenery. All these are the example of singular nouns, and they are always used as singular noun. Others are advice, information, innings, news, summons. Come to the third. Some nouns are used only in plural form. Which are? These are compliments, congratulations, regards, thanks. Now come to the next. Some nouns are used mostly in plural forms. Which are? Arrangements, ashes, crops, peas. Come to the fifth. Some nouns have different meaning as singular and plural. Yes, if they are using as singular, so these meaning will different from the plural. Just see, charge means responsibility, charge or charges means accusations, color of grass, colors of regiments, just like flag, gold is metal, golds is a first prize. Look at here, look of the building, sweet look of the child, manner of doing work, good manners, mean, adjective, midpoint, tin, metal. And come to the means, source or ways of communication, tin or tins means containers. Okay students, so your agreement of subject and verb are completed here, and we will solve your exercise in next video. So let's wait. Thank you so much for watching.